Hey, this is Kevin, the postcard guy here in Sarasota, Florida, with a quick what's sold video. I'm a little bit late on this. I don't think I did one at all last week, so this may be a little bit over a week, closer to almost 2 weeks. But let's take a look at my sales and see how I did. So for the week ending 8/25 today, counting in those 2 weeks, I had 59 sales and a total of $1,865. So a very good 2 week period for me. Been really, really busy. Had a great purchase of old postcards come in. So hopefully you saw part 1, 2, and 3 of my latest haul video. That's been pretty much taking up all my time. And I do have another box of cards just in. So I'll be doing the same hopefully this week. But for this 2 week period, 59 sales, $1,865 was very good for me. That means an average sales price of $31.62. Which for postcards is pretty good. Very happy with that average sales price or ASP of $31.62. I tried something a little bit different this week, a little experiment on my behalf. A lot of my newer cards, my newest things that I'm posting, I'm trying as auction first with a very modest opening bid and then just letting them go where they go. So this week I sold approximately 62% of my sales at auction. I think they went very well. We'll take a look at the sales together and see what you guys think. But what I was doing was I was auctioning off. Then if they didn't sell for some reason, I would take it the following week and make it a fixed price listing. And in general, those prices went up. I listed them at a little bit higher prices as a fixed price listing than if I ran it at auction. So let's take a look and see what sold. First item up is actually not a postcard, but some Lego minifigures. These are some things I bought through the years and put them away, salted them away. So these are some Lego minifigures here that sold for $6.99. And again, I try to sell mostly postcards, but every now and then I do sell occasional other items. The next item up is a postcard. This is the Electric Park Carousel at a town called Niverville, New York. It's up in the Albany and Kinderhook Lake area. This was a A&H railway. A lot of times the railroad companies would actually build these amusement parks along the way, usually close to big cities so they could run an excursion on the weekend, pick up all the people, take them away from their city lives and get them out to the country and visit these type of amusement parks. This is the carousel building there. You can see in view. Card was not used on the back. This was $19.99. I did take a best offer around $17 on this card. Most of my items do have best offer on them. I am very reasonable. If it's an honest offer and not a crazy offer, I can try to take it in most cases. Every now and then I do get that, you know, $40 postcard and I'm willing to offer you $5 type of offer, and I don't entertain those at all. The next one up was a really nice sale here. This is a great postcard here. This is a cab over truck, wooden wheels, chain driven. And this was for an actual Pickle Works, Real Photo Calumet Pickle Works. Schrum Brothers was the name of the company in Illinois. And again, this is a cab over truck. The driver sits right over the engine of the truck, so it's a cab over engine or COE truck. It was not used on the back, but you could see on the side there had all kinds of barrels and crockery holding pickles. And said Calumet Pickle Works. There you go. Schrum Brothers had a Native American motif there. That card was $99.99. I did take a best offer for that one of $79.92. Still a very good sale for me. Next up was a cartoon glass. I do pick up this type of thing as well. This was a Ronald McDonald premium glass. That one there sold for $3. Big Mac. Again, not a huge seller, but if I'm buying them for 50 cents or a quarter, it's still not a bad sale. Over here was an old trading post with gas pumps at Lake George, Glen Falls area. So you had the roadway there with the trading post in view. You could see there were some gas pumps there, mobile gas sign, restaurant signs. This was $29.99. I did take a best offer on this one of $28.25. The next one was not a postcard. This was a car dealer promo back in 1982 when you went and bought a Corvette. This is what they would have given you as a promo giveaway. This was the model of the Corvette you were buying. came in its original box. You can see it's this 1982 Corvette. It was a nice giveaway that the car dealers would have given away that year. So you can see on the license plate, 1982. So if you ever see these in a toy bin and they do have the year on the license plate like that, these are most likely a dealer model. So that was $18.99, and I sold that one for full price. The next one was a Care Bears. I found this with the tag. It's cute, says Care Bears, Bedtime Bear Plush. These are still very popular. I remember these when I was working in Toys R Us many, many years ago back in the 80s. These are the modern day ones now, but they still sell. So if you see those, pick them up. I sold that for a best offer of $17.87. I also sell a lot of Disneyland and Disney World items. This is an old plastic souvenir shopping bag. As you can see, there's a price receipt in the bag. Somebody bought something for, $2.76 in Disneyland. So it's got the bag with all the graphics on it. Somebody thought to save it all these years. And I did pick it up and I sold that empty plastic bag for $9.09. So as you can see, a lot of things sell. Here's an old toy that I picked up out of a flea market tub. This sold for $4.89, 1970 Mattel T-Square Roadster Bucket Car. I remember these when I was a kid for sure. That sold for $4.89. This was a topper for a calendar. Vernon Company, Ohio, Shell Gas Advertising Silhouette. The calendar would be attached to the bottom. This had the advertising up at the top. But what I liked is it had a nice silhouette to it. Would hang on the wall. Nice piece of advertising. Sold for $6.99. This was a nice real photo bus. A Mac Auto Bus Manufacturer Advertising Postcard. What a great looking bus that is. A Mac 20 passenger bus. Had all the Mac advertising on the back. It was going to a Texas person there, transit company. Just a real nice old real photo postcard. You can see the wood spoked wheels. You got the old gas lamps or lamps on the front. Just a nice old bus image. That one was $44.99. I took a best offer of $37.75 on that one. I had some great early aviation cards sell this week. This was the arrival of the NC-4, the first transatlantic flight in 1919. You could see the early aviation, the early ship in view there. This was a floating boat. You could see the man, the sailor in the front of the hull, people, sailors on board. There's some propellers. It is a bi-wing plane. That is a neat old postcard there. It was not postmarked on the back. And that one went off at auction, $49.99, and sold for just one bid. Over here was another one of the same plane, different view. Again, the first transatlantic flight, 1919, in the Azores. Same type idea, floating boat. You could see the men. You could see like a little tugboat in view there. This one also had a unused back, and this one also sold for $49.99. This one here was a neat old liquor delivery truck in front of a store. This was a town called Taunton, Massachusetts, Cohanet Street. You can see the liquor store signs, all the liquor bottles, the wood crates. There's a liquor store delivery truck. Next door you had a merchant tailor and some tire companies, auto tires. All kinds of stuff in view there. It was an electrical contractor. Just a lot going on in view. This sold at auction, one bid, $29.99. The next one was a nice multi-view real photo postcard from Hanover, Pennsylvania. These were the curbside delivery trucks. This was a manufacturer's card to show you what type of trucks they could make for you. This one happened to be a cleaners and a dryer or dyers ink. This one here was a chicken hatchery, poultry truck. This one was a Steiner's truck. This one I especially liked at top. This was Donald Duck bread. So I thought that was really, really cool. And there's the different versions of the trucks. And it was not used on the back, but had tons of advertising on the back. Peterman's Truck Sales, Hanover, Pennsylvania. So we had transportation, had advertising, and it had a local tie-in to Pennsylvania as well. That card sold for one bid of $24.99. Over here to another real photo. This was a horse-drawn parade float, Orange County, New York, Grange horse-drawn float. You can see the people on board there, all dressed up. This was not used on the back. This sold for one bid of $24.99. The next one was a harvesting view. We had a 20 mule train combine harvester at a town called Walla Walla, Washington. I just like saying that. Sold for one bid at $19.99. It was not used on the back, but just a neat old farming scene there. This was a horse and wagon on a country bridge. It was called Index New York, upstate New York. Just had a real nice view of the horses and the wagons coming across the bridge on the county bridge at Index. This card was $39.99. I did take a best offer on that one. Actually, $39.78. Not much less, but I took an offer and accepted. This next one was kind of unique. We had two African American men with a hunting dog and their Model T pickup. You can see the dog there. I thought this was a great image. Don't know for sure where this was, but I love the early automobile. The two gentlemen there, wood spoke cars, and love the dog there. Back was not postally used at all. That sold at auction, four bids, $22.05. That was an example where I set the auction at $19.99. I thought that was a fair value and just let it go to see where it goes. Next up was a Nebraska lineman crew, Northwest Bell Telephone in a town called Walpole, New Hampshire. You see all the men in view. They got their ladders. They're ready to go to work there. They are a telephone lineman crew. Nebraska crew NW Bell Tel at Walpole, New Hampshire. Card back was not used. That card sold full price $39.99. Next one was another great sale here. This was actually a photograph, not a postcard, but it was almost postcard sized. This was Broadway, New York City, which is very unusual to see a motorcycle dealer like this, but there he is. 1916 Indian motorcycle dealer in Broadway section of New York. You can see the great signage there. The Indian motorcycle 1916 on exhibit. You had calendars, you had advertising. There's a motorcycle in the window. Audubon Motorcycle Garage. I love the way they call it Indian motorcycles. I found an old ad for the same company. That's how I knew where it was from. Audubon Motorcycle Garage, H. Raoul. And it was 4192 Broadway near 179th Street. Just a nice old motorcycle related photograph. And again, would be great in a real photo postcard collection. I like the police officer there leaning on the man, probably the owner of the store, and the police officer standing with him. And as you can see, this was posted in an album on the back. Still had black album paper. This sold for four bids of $58 total. Moving right along, we had a Hudson River Railroad station here at Ossining, New York. So just nice old color card, postally used on the back. This sold for $14.99. I listed a lot of railroad stations last week. This is a trolley depot at Ilion, New York. This one was $19.99. It was not used on the back. And I took a best offer of this one, $14.85. This was the Turner Center Creamery Wagon, Providence, Rhode Island, question mark. We know the creamery was in Maine, but we believe the image was taken here delivering to Rhode Island. This sold for three bids of $24.38. You can see on the side there, Turner Center Creamery, which again was up in Maine, and we believe this view here was in Rhode Island. So sold for $24.38. And moving right along, let's go up to the top here and see what we got. We had a real photo of a train in a town called Cadillac, Michigan, 1917 view. You can see all the people getting on and off the train there. Just a nice old view. This was postmarked on the back. Sold this one at auction, $12.50. There were a couple comps. They were in the $12 to $15 range, so I started that one at $9.99. Next one was a horse-drawn trolley. I'm sorry, not a horse-drawn trolley. A trolley and a horse-drawn wagon in view. In the snow, up in a town called Manlius, New York. You can see the trolley in view there. It was not used on the back. This sold for one bid of $24.99. This is another one of the Creamery cards. And if you haven't seen that video, I did put up a video a few weeks ago on milk, creamery, and dairy real photo postcards. So make sure you check that video out. This was the Danville Creamery, North Danville, Vermont. What a tiny little place that is. Built in 1902. Just a very small operation. This is where they make butter. Love the way they said that on the back. And again, just a small little creamery. $29.99 sold for that card. This was a real nice sale here. This was New York Central Railroad Station Depot at Senate, New York. You can see again, small town station. Couple people out front. NYC Station. Senate, New York. Had a lot of writing on the back. And this was $49.99, sold for full price. This was just a t-shirt recently picked up. I picked it up about a week ago. Sold immediately at $24.99, a Janet Jackson tour t-shirt from 2023. So if I find those, I'll sell concert tees as well. As well as things like Starbucks mugs, new in the box. This one sold for, well, it was $20.99. Yeah, sold, took a best offer of $20.99 for that. Over here to some more postcards. This is a steam loco at the railroad, North Lawrence, New York. Just a neat old view there. You can see the steam train coming across the trestle. And this was not used on the back. This sold for one bid of $24.99. This was an old Sinclair dinosaur exhibit at the World's Fair in 1933. Again, anything dinosaur I do very well with. This was a dinosaur display at the fair. This was $9.99. It did take a best offer of about $7 or $8 on that one. This was a large oversized card, and I know postcard people don't like oversized cards generally, but this was a large card from the Sahara Hotel, 1960s, starring Johnny Carson at the Hotel Sahara. So I kind of liked it. I liked the graphics, the Hotel Sahara, featuring the most American girls in the world. The most American girls in the world. Okay. A new high in resort living. Stan Irwin proudly presents Johnny Carson. So I thought that was kind of cool. It was $6.99 on that card, and it sold for full price. This one here was a Knott's Berry Farm ghost town postcard. This is like a diorama at the amusement park. Had a cowboy there and a wagon train. This was $14.99. I took a best offer of this one at about $12 on that. High school basketball program. I'll pick up some paper memorabilia when I find it. This sold for full price of $19.99. This was from Lidgerwood, North Dakota. And it had all the typical ads inside and the scores for the game. And it was kind of cool. I like those type of things. I pick them up when I find them, $19.99. Back to some real photo postcards. This was a school bus. Colby Consolidated Schools in Kansas. Just a nice early school bus vehicle there. This was not used on the back. Sold for one bid at auction, $24.99. This was John Burroughs, a naturalist. He was a poet, a naturalist, driving through Roxbury, New York. Here he is behind the wheel. Undivided back. Sold for one bid of $24.99. This is a nice Valentine's truck, beer truck. Newark, New Jersey, sold for one bid of $24.99. This is Lake Placid pool tables. I guess like a rec room, game room, up in Lake Placid, New York. So you can see the pool table there and some gaming tables. This sold for $34.99. Over here was a ox pulled cart in St. Augustine, Florida. had a nice sugar ad on the side of the cart. I thought that was kind of neat. That card was not postally sent, sold for one bit of $19.99. This card here was a building block in the Adirondacks in a town called Lowville, New York. You can see all the building signage, all kinds of things going on in view there. This card was postmarked on the back. It was $44.99. I think I took a best offer of $39.99 on that one. Next up was an unusual three-wheeled cycle car. So a combination of a motorcycle and a car. It had two wheels in the back, one wheel in the front. You could see it was chain-driven on the side. So there he is driving what they called back then a cycle car. Card was not used on the back. That sold for full price of $29.99. Over here was a linen car dealership. I like these old 40s linens. This had the interior of the waiting room. You had some parts on the wall there. You had some lifts here for cars. So I guess you would actually sit where they worked on your car. You would sit right there in the carpeted area. And this would be the garage area right here. Had some advertising on the back from Syracuse, New York. It sold for one bid of $24.99. Next up was a railway depot station at Ardsley, New York. Small town, upstate New York railroad station. One bid on this one, $19.99. This was a real photo of the world's largest locomotive at the time. It was a printed card, not a real photo. But up in Schenectady, New York, you can see it's quite a huge engine there. And there's the back. That was $19.99. I believe it took best offer on that one about $14.99. Next up was a real photo train station again. DL and W, Delaware, Lackawanna, and Western Railroad Station at Green, New York. Usually most railroad stations, you can look on the side, you'll see this wood plaque here. We'll usually tell you the name of the station if it's not marked. Usually one on the front, one on the back. There's an old luggage carts there. Card was not sent. Sold for one bid of $29.99. And the last one on this page was an old creamery, Rosemary Creamery at Mexico, New York. You could see the old dairy creamery type building. Smokestacks. This card was undivided on the back. I especially like the missent. You can see it's got a stamp. Missent Nassau, New York. So you will see those stamps every now and then. It sold for one bid of $24.99. And on to the last page of cards. Let's see what we got here. This was a railroad station real photo at Camp Dix, Wrightstown, New Jersey. This was an army camp in New Jersey. You can see it says Camp Dix. You got soldiers on the platform there. This card was unused on the back. This card sold for $26 after two bids. This was another nice sale of the week. Hilton and Witt grocery truck and store at a town called Marysville, Washington. I love that they painted the side of the building with all the signage and the advertising. Got a little fire plug there on the corner. Got the grocer standing out front. You've got a real nice delivery truck there. You can see the name of the town, Marysville, on the side. So I had to do a little bit of research to find out that's Marysville, Washington. And you got all kinds of advertising. I put this card up at auction because I could not find anything like it. It's finished up with five bids at $51. Next one up was a real photo steam train. Actually, two steam trains or locomotives at Bennington, Vermont. So it's like the meeting of the trains. They're nose to nose there. Probably for like a publicity photo. That card was not used. And that sold at one bid, $14.99 at auction. Over here was just a coffee mug. Picked it up brand new with a tag. Sold for $14.99. Back to some postcards. Ruins of the Utica Free Academy in Utica, New York. You can see the inside of this school-type building. All the charred books. You got a marble bust up on a shelf, the early firemen helmets that they're wearing and their uniforms. There's water everywhere, unfortunately. This is a series of cards. This one card here sold for $34.99. Over here is another railroad station here, Johnsonville, New York. You can see the steam train there, probably taking on some water. A couple people on the tracks. There's a water tank there. This card was used on the back, postmarked, it looks like 1903, maybe. Just a neat old view, $29.99 on that card. And over here, this was the Railroad Crossing Railroad Station at Vale Mills, Mayfield, New York. Yeah, nice little country view there of the town. You got a little speedway here going into town. You got railroad train crossing. There's the sign, Railroad Crossing Lookout for the cars. And there's the Vales Mills station. Again, not much of a station. It's like a one-room house. And this would have been a railroad station or probably a trolley car. But I think this is railroad for sure. This sold for one bid of just $29.99. And the last card of the week that sold, this was a nighttime view of a fire at a piano factory in Middletown, New York. It was dated 1911. Card front down here says Piano Factory Fire, the old Draper Building, Middletown, New York, April 26, 1911. You don't often see real photo nighttime scenes, and a nighttime fire is quite amazing that the photographer ran out there to take the pictures at night. And then brought the images back, made them into postcards, and then went around town to sell them to drugstores and people. And kind of a neat old card. It was not used on the back. This sold for full price, $29.99. So again, that's what I sold this week. Week ending 8/25. Again, about 59 sales for a total of about $1,800. That does represent a two-week period. So that's about right, about $900 a week or so. And again, my average sales price is still hovering around $30, $31, so I've been very happy with that. So if you like this video, please make sure to give me a thumbs up. Hit like on the video, that really does help my channel. And if you'd like to subscribe, you will be notified by clicking that bell icon when my next video is up and ready to be watched. Once again, I am Kevin the Postcard Guy here in Sarasota, Florida, and I hope you enjoyed seeing what sold this week. Thanks so much for watching.